Hey guys, Mr. here again for another video today, and we are back with a new series I am doing on my channel. We are back, and I was doing this series back in NHL 17, so I decided to bring it back for NHL 18. If you guys were here for the NHL 17 series, it was, I guess we could call it, Can They Win the Stanley Cup? So, yeah, first episode, we're going to see if my hut team can win the Stanley Cup. So, I mean, this should be an interesting one. We have, here's the lineup, I guess. I'll show you my hut team. We have Rocket Skates, Fine Shooting, Silky Smooth, and Thread the Needle all active. Just if you guys wanted to know. So, it's definitely not the greatest hut team in the world, but it's still pretty solid. So we've got Curry, Modano, and Draisaitl on the top line. Kucherov, Taves, and Laine on the second line. Hall, Sagan, and Arvidsson on the third line. And then Couture, Getzlaff, and Stone on the fourth line. Top two, D, Doughty, and Yossi. Second pair, Petrangelo and Keith. Third pair, Jones and Werenski. And then the goalies are Bobrovsky and Donis, I don't know. And then our coach is Michael Davidson, but he doesn't really matter for this episode. So yeah, the first episode of this one should be an interesting one. I checked the rating of what this team is, and it's actually unreal. We have a, I believe, 97 overall team. I didn't mean to click load. See, that was the previous attempt at recording this, but then I added in Ryan Johansson instead of Tyler Seguin because I forgot that I sold Ryan Johansson literally earlier today and then got Tyler Seguin. So yeah, my bad about that. But yeah, we are going to be the Toronto Hut. That is going to be the team name I decided. The next closest closest overall teams to us are Nashville, Pittsburgh, and Tampa, I believe, who are all 92 overall, and we are 97 overall, I believe it was. Yeah, 97 overall. So you know, that is quite the team, that's for sure. Now I'm gonna keep auto rotate goalies on just for the main fact. I don't know. Jan Donis, for some reason, I'm going to explain this right now, I guess. Obviously, since Modano and Curry aren't actually in franchise mode, I had to create those two players, but I also had to create Jan Donis. So all three of them, for what I did, or what I did for them, I guess, I created the player, and then I gave them all their stats that are actually in HUT. So I gave them the exact same stats that they have on their HUT card that I have. So I just decided to do that for creating the player. I had to create Jan Donis because I couldn't find him anywhere. Like, it says he's on the Laval Rocket. He wasn't there, and I checked former teams that he used to play for. He wasn't there. I didn't see him in free agency either. Like, I searched up Jan Donis, and it said that he was a unrestricted free agent, and he wasn't in the free agency column when I was adding my players to the team. So I don't know why or what happened, but whatever. So taking a look at the team, we have 100 offense, 98 defense, and 91 goaltending. So quite the team, that's for sure. Now I'm gonna make the lineup the way I have it in HUT, just so you guys know. So yeah, let's make this, and we'll see what it looks like. If I remember correctly, I believe that is what the entire team looks like. So we have our left wingers of Curry, Laine, Arvidsson, and Stone. Our centers of Getzlaff, Sagan, Taves, and Modano. And then our right wingers of Draisaitl, Kucherov, Hall, and Couture. And look at that center depth, though. Modano, Taves, Sagan, and Getzlaff. So Curry, I mean, he can't get any better. Absolutely unreal offensive stats, obviously. Very, very good. And then Modano, same thing. Why he's listed as a grinder, he shouldn't be. I should have him Actually, was he listed as a grinder? I think he might have been listed as a grinder. Honestly, I do not remember. But, yeah, I will also show you the defense. We have Yossi and Doughty. And then we have Petrangelo and Keith, Werenski and Jones, of course. And then our goalies are Bobrovsky and Donis. Donis really brings down our goaltending. But, I mean, there was nothing I could do. I created him, and he's 10 overall lower than his hut card for some reason. I have no idea why, but he is. So I'm just going to check really quickly why Medano was listed as a grinder. I'm pretty sure he's not listed as a grinder when I checked that yesterday, or when I made these cards yesterday. Yeah, he's listed as a two-way forward. So I think I actually, can I change that? I do not know. Okay, I can. So I will change Medano really quickly to a two-way forward. And I know I didn't list him as a franchise player either. I don't know why he is a franchise player right now. What am I looking for? Two-way. Yeah, okay, two-way. So he is the captain. I was going to say we would have him as the captain. If he was, or if you could have captains and assistants in Hutt like you used to be able to. I'd also have Petrangelo as an assistant, and then the other one, I don't really know. I've just had Petrangelo for the longest time, so I think it's been long overdue, but it is time to simulate with the Toronto Hutt team. You guys have seen the team. Obviously, we aren't going to make any trades. I expect for us to make the playoffs, but we'll see how we do. Like I said, this team is really good. I just... we may be in trouble looking or when we have back-to-backs, because Donis will be in net and Donis will be extremely poor. Although, I don't know. I mean, who knows? We have a pretty solid record so far, but getting some losses. We're actually getting quite a few losses. Man, imagine this team in the NHL right now. It would be unreal. Well, I mean, that's not true. I was going to say it would be unreal, but who knows? How good, well, if you take Medano and Curry when they were in their prime and then put them on this team right now, could you imagine? This team would be unreal. That would be quite something. And Bobrovsky is playing absolutely phenomenally right now over there in Columbus. It's crazy how good he is doing. I mean, honestly, I think Bobrovsky is the best goalie in the world. I mean, that's another concept for another video to talk about, but... although Price just came back tonight, well, at the time of recording this, and he had a 36-save shutout in his return. But still, like I said, I think Bobrovsky is probably the best goalie in the world right now. He's actually so crazy in net. He makes some of the most ridiculous saves. Like, he had one on Jacob De La Rose a few nights ago. I think it was last week. Oh my god, I actually freaked out when I saw it. It was such an amazing save. It was so cool. I lost it. I don't know what it was. It's just absolutely phenomenal save. I don't know why the simulation is just deciding to pause, but just before the deadline, we have a record of 45-7-8, which is obviously really good. I mean, we could be on pace for 60 wins, but then again, who knows? Will we be able to get those 60 wins? If I do the math, do we even have enough games to get there? We have 60 games played, so yeah, we only have, well, yeah, we have 22 games played, or 22 games to play, and 21 games to play now, so we definitely could get the 60-win season, whether it will happen or not. Who knows? Two big losses against LA, and yeah, I don't know. This team's kind of streaky. I mean, we obviously went on some big win streaks, but we've got quite a few losses this year. Didn't expect to get so many losses. Obviously, I mean, I say that, but you know, we had a 60-win season. But like I said, still, I really anticipated to have more wins. Or not more wins, but less losses for sure. Well, yeah, I guess more wins then. I definitely didn't expect to have 14 regulation losses. We'll simulate up to the day to see who we are playing in the playoffs, because we are going to do the playoffs as well, and we'll see if we can win the Stanley Cup. Obviously, that's the goal. If you guys didn't know, if you couldn't tell by the title of this series. So let's see, we finished with a record of 60-14-8. Obviously, going to be the best team in the league. 128-point season is unreal, that's for sure. Jari Kurri was the leading point scorer on the team. Wow, no one was even near close to that after him. I mean, I would have liked to see Modano put up more points. Maybe if I had him as a playmaker or sniper, he would have. Kucherov, 68 points on that second line. Maybe Draisaitl really held them back on that top line. Although, man, actually, maybe I should have tried to have Kucherov, Modano, and Kurri on a line together. I did have Kucherov on my top line, but I just got that Evolution Draisaitl, and I put him on the top line just to see how he does. Let's go check our goalies. Bobrovsky played a really good season. He had 59 games played, 48 wins, and a .930 save percentage. Donis, though, he played a lot of games. I would have liked to for him to play a lot less, and he had an .889 save percentage. So let's go see the entire league. Bobrovsky actually had the most wins and actually could win the Vezina this year. Who knows? Let's go check our skaters. Jari Kurri had the most points in the league. The real Nikita Kucherov was top four in the league, or top three technically, I guess, if you consider Stamkos and Kane. But yeah, I really would have liked to see more points from Modano. Like I said, maybe if I had him as a playmaker or a sniper, he would have done better. But then again, I mean, what can you do? So we go up against the St. Louis Blues in the first round. I did not mean to go to there. I meant to go to the calendar. Come on, calendar. There we go. And yeah, let's just sim the first round of the playoffs. We'll see how we do. We'll go game by game. So game one in the first round, we win. Game two, we win. Game three, let's go. Come on, we win. Game number four in the first round, we lose. So we don't sweep the St. Louis Blues. Game number five, we win. So we move on to the second round of the playoffs, and we'll see who we face in that round. Let's go. We will face the San Jose Sharks. Interesting. So they won in the first round in six games. Let's go. Game number one, we beat them. All right, 1-0 series lead. Game number two, we win. We are now 6-1 in the playoffs, now 7-1. We won game three. Game number four, we lost. Man, game number four is our kryptonite right now. And then we win in game number five. Exact same series, basically, against St. Louis and against San Jose. So we now meet the Chicago Blackhawks in the Western Conference Finals. Let's go. Game number one of the Western Conference Finals, we win. Game number two, we lose. All right. Game number three, we win. 7-2 victory. Game number four, we win. Game number five, we win. So another five-game series, and we have a 12-3 record heading to the Stanley Cup Final against the Tampa Bay Lightning. We simulated game one, which is fine. I didn't mean to, but we won game one. Game number two, we win. Okay. Game number three, we win. And it's time for game number four. We're going to go in and sim the game because obviously we've got to go check out the celebration if we do win the Stanley Cup. So first period, we're up 1-0. Our Nikita Kucherov scores to make it 1-0. Second period, Ryan Getzlaf scores to make it 2-0. And we will simulate the third period. We'll slow sim it. And 5-on-3 power play for Tampa. All right, well, looking good so far. Looking like episode one could be a successful one. Looking like we may be able to win the Stanley Cup. Although Nikita Kucherov makes it a... Oh, stop the sim. Okay. Kucherov makes it a one-goal game. All right, well, let's go in. Andre Palat tied the game. Okay. Well, I tried stopping the sim. Now, looking like we're going to overtime. All right, well, we are going to overtime. Now, not that I want to go in and watch the entire overtime. I don't know. I don't really want to do that. So let's see. Power play for Tampa. Tampa, do you just want to win this game for me then? Please. You just want to win so I can see I want to see us. All right, good. Braden Point gets the game winner. All right, well, game number four goes to Tampa. Again, another game four that we lose. Time for game number five now, and we'll see if we can win the Stanley Cup in this one. We kind of had a little bit of a choke in that last one, that's for sure. First period, we're up 1-0, Mike Modano. Second period, tied 1-1, Steven Stamkos tied the game. Time for the third period now. Can we get the lead? Not looking like there's a lot of scoring in the playoffs for us, although Modano gets his second goal of the game. Don't know how many goals he's got this playoff run, but we'll check out the stats at the end. 5.5 minutes to go. Looking pretty good for the Toronto Hut team. 38 seconds left, and we'll go in and see if we can win the Stanley Cup in the last 40 seconds. Wow, holy frig. Tampa is good. 93, 95, and 90. Although 198 and 91 is pretty good too. That's for sure. Yeah, well, let's go head in for the Stanley Cup final game. Now, I am not going to play the game just because I don't want to, you know. Actually, I might have to play the game just so we actually do see the celebration. There's only a few 30-ish seconds left, so might as well. We'll just see if get another one. Although it is All-Star, with my luck, I'll lose this game. I didn't really care too much about the jerseys. I just made them purple. I don't know. Purple's my favorite color, so that's what I decided to go with. As Jones passes it up to Arvidsson, passes it up to Taves. Taves, give her buddy. Around Strahlman, comes in, couldn't get anything going. Back to Werenski, to Jones, gets checked by Killorn, and here comes to Tampa, probably to tie the game. Oh my god, could you imagine? I'd actually be so upset. Not gonna lie, Kucherov skates, and he will get the empty netter more than likely. Yes, he will. Alright, so Kucherov nets the empty netter, and there we go. So episode 1 was most definitely a successful one. Kucherov with a 6 of the playoffs. And yeah, there we go, boys. We win the Stanley Cup. So episode 1 was most definitely a successful one. We win the Stanley Cup with my Hut team. That just proves that my Hut team's pretty solid. That means we could win the Stanley Cup. That's pretty awesome, to be honest. I like that. That's awesome. So I mean, we'll watch the celebration, and then we'll check out some stats and also end the episode there. But I kind of don't like this little part of the celebration. It takes too long. I mean, I get it. I understand. It's basically the same way as real life, but still, I don't know. I love how there's just the goalie stick there, and there's no other sticks there. Look at that home ice logo with the H. All right, let's see. Who is the Conn Smythe winner? Maybe Bobrovsky? Although, I don't know, to be honest. Let's see. Come on, hurry up. I really like the celebration. It's so much better than the last one. And Bobrovsky gets the Conn Smythe. But yeah, like I was saying, oh my god, a 945 save percentage for Bobrovsky and a 1.52 GAA. That is really good stats. But yeah, like I was saying, I really like the celebration this year. It's so much better than last year's, but it also takes a little while to lead up to this part, to the winning of the Stanley Cup. And Mike Modano, the captain, will be able to raise it first. Let's see. Come on, boys. Go get the cup. All right. Looking good so far. Mike Modano, buddy. Come on. Get that cup, bro. Looking good. Hopefully you guys enjoy this series. Let me know if you do, of course. I think this will be a fun one because, obviously, I mean, I'm going to continue this, and hopefully you guys will enjoy it. Obviously, you guys can give me suggestions as well of people, or of teams, I guess, you guys want to see. Taylor Hall gets the Stanley Cup. Nice, nice, nice. we'll see who gets it third. The third guy's always the most selfish one, I'm pretty sure. He just keeps going with it. Who gets it? Doughty? Was that Doughty? Yeah, Doughty gets it. I believe he's one of our assistants right now. I wasn't too worried about the captaincy and assistancy. As long as Madonna was captain, I guess, really. Yeah, go for another skate there, Doughty, you selfish guy. Sorry, had to cough there for a second. All right, boys. Can we get to the picture now? I feel like I'm complaining so much. Although, like I said, I really hope you guys enjoy this. Yeah, give that cup to Bob. What a freaking beast. Line A wins a cup in his second year. What a beast. All right, let's see. What will the team picture look like? There we go. Captain Medano, Doughty's an assistant. I don't know who the other assistant is, though, to be honest. And there's the team. What a beauty team it is. Awesome. Where's Yari Curry at? I actually don't know. Didn't see him there, because I just have him as the base created player face. Wow, Bobrovsky, 958 save percentage. Unreal, that's for sure. Medano was the first star with 2 goals. Very, very good. Now let's go and check the stats. We won the Stanley Cup, boys. Very good. Let's see it. The Stanley Cup champions, the Toronto Hut team, with a record of 60, 14, and 8. Obviously really good. Let's go and check some stats now, boys. So, let's check some awards, I guess. Stanley Cup goes to us. President's Trophy goes to us. Clarence S. Gamble Bowl goes to us. And we beat Tampa in the final. Art Ross goes to Curry. Hart goes to Curry. Norris goes to Keith on Chicago. Lady Bing goes to Patrick Kane. Calder goes to Clayton Keller. Conn Smythe goes to Bobrovsky. Vezina goes to Bobrovsky, which is very good. We did have some hardware out there. Mike Medano's apparently on New York as well. I don't think that's right, but okay. Selke went to Medano. Ted Lindsay went to Curry, and Maurice Richard also went to Curry. Curry had a season, boys. Holy frig. Well, let's go check our playoff stats, and we'll end the episode there. So, Mike Medano, a point-per-game player in the playoffs. Didn't have the greatest regular season, but he was there in the playoffs. Kucherov with 17 points. Yari Curry with 16 points. Taylor Hall with 14. Who had the most goals? It was definitely Medano. We had a few other goal scorers that did pretty well. Most assists goes to Curry, I think. Yeah, Curry and Kucherov. Very, very interesting, that's for sure. Did everybody get a point throughout the playoffs? Everybody got a point throughout the playoffs. Not too bad. Now, out of curiosity, did anybody grow? I mean, I doubt it, but it's possible. Line A didn't grow. Did Kucherov or Draisaitl? I think Draisaitl went up one. I think he might have been an 86. Don't quote me on that, though. I'm honestly not too sure. Hall didn't grow. Kucherov, he might have grown. He might have been 89, honestly. Don't remember. And then the goalies, obviously Bobrovsky with a 945 save percentage. 1.52 GAA is unreal. So thank you guys so much for watching this first episode of Can They Win the Cup, I guess, or what Can They Win the Stanley Cup. And yeah, great, great season from the Toronto Hut team. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you all did enjoy, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.